YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. I think understanding comes before creation. So before we build a sun, we must first ask the question, what is a sun? Well, a sun is a star, and a star is a massive luminous sphere of superheated gas held together by gravity. But let's look at things in more detail. Okay, so stars form in structures called giant molecular clouds, which exist in the interstellar medium, and they're comprised mainly of hydrogen, some helium, and little bits of dust. These clouds are thinly dispersed throughout space and are typically between 50 and 200 light years across. They are also very cold, something in the order of 10 Kelvin. To put this in perspective, a block of ice is about 270 Kelvin. Over time, gravity will cause the cloud to collapse in on itself and begin to form knots of matter. Due to Newton's law of universal gravitation, over time more and more matter will clump together at these knots. As more matter collapses, the density increases, gravitational energy is converted into heat, and the temperature also increases. When the temperature is high enough, the now spherical gaseous clump will begin to dimly glow and a protostar is born. After the birth of a protostar, the density and temperature will continue to rise until we reach 18 million degrees Kelvin. At this point, the temperature and density in the core of the protostar is high enough to achieve thermonuclear fusion. Thermonuclear fusion is the process by which atoms collide and fuse to form other atoms. In this case, hydrogen atoms are being forced together to form helium atoms. Once nuclear fusion occurs, our protostar is no longer a protostar, but rather a main sequence star. As a byproduct of hydrogen burning, each time two atoms are fused together, a photon of light is emitted. This will cause the star to shine in its own right, rather than just passively glow. Our sun, for example, converts 400 million tons of hydrogen into helium every second, and as a result, puts out 1 times 10 to the power of 45 photons of light every second. That is 1 with 45 zeros after it. Even despite this immense power output, the main sequence is a relatively calm period of a star's life. A star will spend the majority of its 10 billion year lifespan here happily burning away hydrogen and radiating off heat. Hydrostatic equilibrium between the gravity and the star's radiation pressure keeps it stable while it's in the main sequence. However, once all the hydrogen is converted into helium, nuclear fusion in the core temporarily stops. Gravity will then cause the star to start collapsing in on itself again, which, like before, increases temperature and pressure. The core will eventually get hot enough for the nuclear fires to reignite. Helium is now fused together to form a new atom, carbon. This helium burning will last a mere 100 million years or so, and because of the relatively low mass of a sun-like star, when all the helium is consumed, gravity will not be able to supply the necessary energy needed for further nuclear fusion. As a result of the heat produced from this helium burning, the star's outer layers will expand to hundreds of times their original size. Here the star has moved off the main sequence and has become a red giant star. When our sun becomes a red giant, it would potentially expand up to 256 times its current size. At this point, its outer layers would engulf Mercury, Venus, and Earth and continue extending out to near Mars orbit. Our star will begin to shed its outer layers in fits and starts. Large amounts of matter are ejected into the interstellar medium in these cosmic bursts. The ejected material forms what is known as a planetary nebula. With the outer layers gone, all that will remain is a small core or stellar remnant. Gravity can no longer collapse this core due to a process called electron degeneracy. That is, electrons naturally wish to repel each other, and it is this repulsion that will balance against the force of gravity. This now stable stellar remnant is known as a white dwarf, a very dense object as massive as a star but only about the size of Earth. It is so dense that a teaspoonful of white dwarf material will weigh several tons. A white dwarf will then, for billions of years, peacefully radiate away any of its remaining heat. Once totally cool, it will linger in space for an eternity as a black dwarf. So there you have it, the life and death of a sun-like star. Guys, please like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Edgar out.